Hey folks, this is Beston Slot. Welcome back to Newdale Zoo, our Amsterdam-inspired park build. And as someone pointed out in the comment section of the last video, it should actually be based on Lake Town more than Newdale, or Dale I should say, but that's beside the point. Today we're going to work on the fallow deer habitat, but I say we're working on the habitat, really it's more working on the area around it. I mentioned that I wanted to do a Christmas market sort of shebang. And that's really what we're going to focus on mainly today. So I had this vision of, you know, you've got Christmas markets and they've got like a little petting zoo. This is me looking for reference images. Christmas markets, you've got all the petting zoos going around. You're not going to pet the deer per se, but maybe you can feed it or something. And, you know, they're there and they're friendly and they're fluffy and kids love them and blah, blah, blah. That's the kind of vibe. But I really wanted a centerpiece. I had in my mind I used to go to the Christmas markets in Manchester or Liverpool. Where Liverpool I went? I can't remember. I've been to both, but there was one in particular where there's this big tall building, like a clock tower in the middle of the market, and they had a big Santa on it. I don't have the big Santa. I might make a big Santa, but I didn't have. The point is, there was a big clock tower, and it kind of stood as the central place where the market kind of built around. So I wanted to give a go at building a clock tower sort of thing, a bell tower, because I've wanted to build a bell tower for the whole park so far anyway, because there's a new European bell, this big brass thing you can see there, and it's really cool. It's a really nice item, so I really wanted to use it. And also, this is typically the kind of building I would say I'm not particularly good at. Not something I've done very often, because I think there's if I've got one problem with Planet Zoo's building items at the moment, there's very few ones that start. Very few angular pieces that kind of come together in a thinner point, if that makes sense. You can't go from a square to a smaller square very easily. There's very few points, like items, that lead in that direction. So you have to kind of fiddle around, official term, with lots of different building pieces and angle them all together and rotate them around to do that kind of thing. But I'm really happy with how it turned out eventually. It's really cool. The whole build, this is a super long build you're watching here. There will be some jumps every now and again in my recording program. Again, only with Planet Zoo. I think there's something I'm doing at some point that it stops recording. I've probably missed about an hour in total, but it is a 10-hour build, so an hour or so doesn't really matter. I spent ages doing this, absolutely ages. The time just got away from me. I didn't really mind. It wasn't bothering me at any point. I'm still really enjoying the park, the city. But, bloody Nora. So anyway, yeah, this was my first goal. Just make this look as good as possible, and then we'll light it up at night and make it all Christmassy in a little bit. But I've gotten pretty good at this kind of thing, I think. I think it looks really good, actually, already. I think just using these building items, these same ones I've been doing for the entire zoo so far, is something I've become very comfortable with, in how to combine the limestone and the brick in particular to make things look good. Bringing in more of the brass this time around to give it a little bit more of a luxurious feel. You know, this is a centerpiece for this area, so it should kind of stand out and be important. And just trying new things again, like here with the brackets, just mixing things up and changing how things look, doing things I haven't done before, which is one of the major problems I have with the building designs is I've done so many buildings at this point that it's quite hard for me to come up with something I haven't done before. So I want to keep experimenting and hopefully come up with some brand new ideas. And in my head, you could walk through the middle of it. There's nothing really in there in the build, but obviously because this is two blocks wide, you have to finagle it a little bit to get the center to work. You can't just use the grid. You have to make your own thing essentially. So that's what I'm doing here. It is worth noting, you'll see me sort of faff around with it in a little bit, that the grid is off. Somewhere along the way, the grid is off a little bit. And this raised area here does not perfectly match the grid of the area that walks by the side of it, on the other side of the Christmas market area. And it is breaking my heart. I really thought I was in a lot of trouble. I've kind of made it work, I think, and you can do so, but it's definitely not. I don't know how it's happened. I don't know where it's possibly occurred, but it is heartbreaking stuff. So just decorating the area a little bit. Again, my philosophy with Planet Zoo really is just, I just do whatever I feel like at the time, you know, whatever's striking me in the moment. And I think that's a good way to approach like a really long build like this. That way you don't burn yourself out quite as much. Just messing around with some buildings, making sure that, changing this one up a little bit, because I've already used this building before and it's quite a noticeable building. It's quite large, it's got a very particular design, so just changing up the colours and stuff so it stands out a little bit less. Stop vibrating, thank you very much. So, Crescent Market. Obviously, we need some little stalls, little market stall things where people will be selling lots of different food items and drink items and little handcrafted things and stuff like that. It's the best part of the market, is seeing all these random little shops. It's a lot of fun. What was that noise? But I realised the problem pretty quickly here, because I wanted them to actually be stalls. And you see I've got tons of these set up in the area, but the problem is the path tool in this game is so bad sometimes, and it's very, very difficult to have so many stalls in close proximity. So you can see here what I've done is delete the path, and then I'm going through, I'm just trying to get them all to link together, all these different stalls to link together, and I realized pretty quickly they were just too close together. There's too many of them, and there's no way the world is going to allow me to do this. The game is going to keep fighting me on this. This is actually, again, something I'm going to keep doing for the foreseeable future now. This kind of thing I'm doing, where I'm overlaying this breeze block across the entire ground, is making my life so much better. It really is, because there's no way I could get away with a path this ugly if you were actually walking on the path, right? It would look really bad. But because you don't see the path, it doesn't actually matter. And stick a little, you know, star on top, and just some random decoration items, just make these look a little bit prettier, a little bit Christmassier. It's an official term. And just make them look pretty, basically. I still need to do a little bit more work on these. I think the stalls are pretty empty. There's the initial bit with the of the actual stall itself, but then the rest of the tent is devoid of anything, and I'd like to put some stuff in there. I'm not quite sure what yet. And time for lights though. So, you know, got these lampposts, got these new antler lights. They've got a stretch between the lampposts. Looks really nice. So they're like above your head as you walk through. A lot of Christmas places do stuff like that. And some lights for the actual tower as well. What I like about this is you can barely notice it in the daytime. At night it looks very over the top, very colourful, very funky. But in the daytime it really just looks like the tower. The actual little light up bits are quite hard to notice. And just sticking some lights on the buildings as well. Figure this is a nice Christmassy area. People would be decorating their houses. Part of the charm, you know? And so that's what we're doing. Just hanging lights up. Making things look sexy. Gotta make it sexy. And everyone knows Christmas is the sexiest holiday. Oh, any more of those signs? I forgot. I haven't done that yet. Putting some trees in. Trees are really good. There's all this blank space and that deeply upsets me. So I have to sort that out. I really like the idea as well of having a... I'm going to get rid of that wall in a second. I'm messing around, as I've said a lot, with height and hiding things under things, and we really wanted you to walk under a bridge. That was like one of the main things, so got a little bridge there that you're going to be able to walk underneath. And again, I really like the idea of there being like a little shop both under the bridge and under the market itself to an extent. There was a bar that I used to go to in Manchester that was underneath this gigantic bridge and kind of built into the side of the wall, so it's kind of inspired by that. And it's a coffee shop, and it's Amsterdam, so, you know, it's kind of appropriate to have a coffee shop, inverted commas. Street Fox Coffee is taking on a whole different business approach in Amsterdam. It's not Amsterdam, it's New Dale, is what it's called. But yeah, so, just working on the bridge, ticking up those pillars a little bit. I might make some changes to the bridge. The bridge is fairly gigantic, and I ended up lighting it up, just like with the other one, so it looks like a little bit too much. Maybe I've got a little bit of an idea to bring that in, but we'll see. Just doing a little bit of concrete work. I keep mixing it up basically between working on the market, working on the deer habitat, which obviously hasn't even started yet, and working on general things in the area. I did a lot of work for this build here. The city really, really expands. There's a couple of things that I did before the build even starts. You may catch it here and there. If you look to the left of what we worked on in the last video, across the water from where the ferry was, I've put a load of buildings there, like backside facing the ferry. Bloody Nora. You can see them there on the left. Because as I mentioned, that's quite a common thing in Amsterdam. The backs of the buildings will look out straight onto the canal. And there's no pathway there or anything like that. It's just the back of the building looks out over the water, basically. So I wanted to incorporate that. And it also looks better than just having, you know, a giant field, basically. That is my one big concern with this zoo build in general is... how I'm going to finish it, essentially, and make it look good. Because it's a city, you can't just like cover the surrounding in trees, I don't think, and have it look okay. So I don't know what I'm going to do, but I'll keep thinking about that. I think I might just end up putting tons of buildings in, and then some trees behind them, and maybe that'll pull it together. But I don't want it to look like the city is the size I build it. I want it to look like it's far-ranging and expanding way beyond what you can see. You know what I mean? Anyways, so working on the area here for the deer habitat, I had a rough idea of what I was going to do, but this is very much still in the planning phases. As you can see by the fact that I'm building this raised area, which I ended up deleting, and all that path around the back ends up going as well, and it's just kind of putting in shapes, putting in path, putting in flooring, and just trying to figure out what I want this to look like. I knew that I wanted a barn, or like a warm, this area here that I'm building, which is also slight, I don't know where it went wrong, I really don't. The left, right, and bottom walls, from this perspective, are fine, but that top wall is slightly out. Again, I've got no idea how that's happened, but somewhere along the way, my grid has gone mad. It's really breaking my heart, but it is what it is. Again, I'm very inspired by Bloodborne. I've got this level design kind of philosophy rolling through my head constantly, wherein I want everything to wrap around and connect in interesting sort of ways. You know, that's very much a big driving force of what I'm doing here. But anyways, yeah, this is the barn kind of thing. The idea is that this is where you'd go and see the deer, and they'd be inside and warm, and you could observe them, and they'd be eating from feeders, stuff like that. And just trying to balance. You can see the reason I'm putting the wood there is because I was realizing very quickly this is out of place. But I didn't know why, so I just thought, you know what, we'll just go for it. We'll just, that one line is going to be constantly out of place. I will have to keep rotating to accommodate for it. And there's going to be a lot of work here on this. I did quite a lot of work on the wooden structure underneath the barn. I don't think you'll ever really notice, but made me happy. Basically, I think I spent like an hour just on this bloody barn thing. Mainly on this freaking corner, apparently. Bear in mind, this is 1500% speed to make this, you know, time lapse. Short enough that I could actually put it in a bloody video, and still spent that long on the corner. So yeah, just working on the roof, keeping it relatively simple, using the Arctic stuff, which isn't something we've really used much, but it's very appropriate for the Christmas kind of theme, and I think it's nice to have areas of the park, like there's always these constant materials. I think that's very important. So I've got the same sort of foliage throughout the entire park. I've got the same sort of materials in general. There's lots of breeze block, there's lots of rustic stone, there's a lot of limestone, there's a lot of brick. But different areas should have a new material that comes in. So the Arctic wood is used quite a lot in this area because it's Christmassy. And it makes that area feel individual. Feels like a new level of video game, essentially, which is kind of what I'm going for in a way. My one concern at the moment is integrating the revolutionary storyline because I don't know how to do it. I'm thinking what it's going to end up being is not really integrated per se, in that it's just this thing that kind of sits in the background, and there might be little references, but I don't need to base like an entire exhibit around the revolutionaries. I think that's the kind of thing that has hurt me in the past in a way, you know, that focus on theme over everything else. Whereas now it's more, I mean, it's very heavily themed, it's a bloody city, but the storyline is taking a little bit of a backseat. It's definitely there, it's always in my mind, but I'm not really doing much to accommodate it quite yet. Anywho, working on the barn, just using, I love these things, these, I can't remember what they're called, it's like a trellis looking thing. And really just going to try out materials, just see what fits, see what, oh, I need to bring that tree back, I ended up getting rid of it. The thing I like to do is bring in a staff member, they're hired just for that purpose, but you bring in a staff member and kind of see how they would view the habitat, you know, you can kind of get a view of that eye level and what they'd be able to see if they looked into the habitat, essentially. Yeah, just messing around with fence ideas. I really like the trellis thing, so I want to use that as much as possible, basically. Hiccups. Just combining all the different Arctic wood shapes to hopefully make something that looks good, basically. Nice and simple. A bit of edging there on the bottom. Everyone loves a little bit of edging. How has that come up twice in two episodes? Maybe that's the theme of the series. The themes of this build are revolutionaries and edging. Anyways, beamed, big old pieces of wood, right down the middle, and this was meant to be fairly chill. I was just going to kind of build this shape, and I thought, well, that doesn't really make sense, that's not really going to hold up the building, and I thought, oh, well, we'll add a bit more then, and I thought, oh, well, that won't hold up the building, we'll have to add a little bit more, and it just kind of became much more elaborate than I ever really planned, this wooden shell kind of sustaining the shed. I know it's very hard to see what's actually going on here when I'm doing quite quick cuts and very intricate work, but there's nothing else I can do. I was going to cut the video into two because it was such a long build. I probably should have cut it into two, actually, in retrospect. I should have done a Christmas market build and then the deer, but you know, I didn't. So here we are. Yeah, more beams. Like, I figured it doesn't make sense for the shell to just sit atop it and only be supported by the outsides. So there needs to be some in the middle. Bringing in our nice modern lights, the same ones we use in the Badgers. Again, nice bit of consistency, but also just, yeah. Actually, I found that, you know, I was working on a lot of areas in the daytime, and this whole area is quite shaded. It just happens to be quite shadowy. And if you swap to nighttime and turn your light on, it's actually potentially easier to do quite a lot of building in those shadowy areas. I think you can see more at night with your light on, which you turn on by pressing L, compared to building in the daytime in the shadows. And I was messing around the time of day, but I just couldn't get light, like, inside, you know, or into the roof of the shed. That was never going to happen, so... yeah, basically. Using the deer carvings, technically it's a reindeer, technically, but it's a deer in it, it's a bloody deer in it. You know, it is what it is. My major problem at this point was that the roof wasn't looking very interesting, and I knew I wanted to do something to make the roof a little bit more interesting to look at. So I put an eave on there, and then this was really the kick. It was just lining the edges with big old pieces of wood, basically. And that just gave it a little bit more detail. It's not going to be over the top, because it shouldn't be. It's not the focus. But it had to have something there just to brighten up a little bit. And I think this was subtle enough to do that job, basically. Oh, I was thinking that. If you see me disappear, it's because A, I'm looking at references, or B, I'm changing my music. It's always one of the two. I don't know how people would ever do this without listening to music. It would drive me insane. It really would. So I want to give a shout out here. These are the only workshop items I've used so far. There's a person called Lida. Doesn't have a YouTube channel. I'm going to link it down below. But also does workshop items. And we're following on Twitter as well. And they made a series. I'm using two of their workshop items. One of them is feeders, which is these feeders you can see here. Again, you'll see all this in a little bit more detail when we get into game at the end of this bit. But here I'm just building like a fence for the Christmas tree to keep the kiddiewinks away. Basically, no Christmas for the children. I googled images of Christmas trees in markets, and this is kind of what they do. They just want to protect it a little bit, you know, and dot some presents around, make it Christmassy, blah 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 blah. Anyway, they did a series of feeders, which are like just made with wood, and they look really, really good. They're really well. Sorry, stretching. If it sounded weird, they're really, really beautifully well made. So I use those, if I'm a deer, both inside and outside, because I'm going to build a separate building at the back. The idea is that in the daytime, or like in the early evening, the deer can hang out in. They've got like an outside area, which we'll do in a little bit, and they've got the area you just saw, they've got the barn, and that's where you can view them. But then at night, when visitors are gone and stuff like that, the deer will go into their own little home. And I'll be building that in a little bit as well. This is meant to be just a slightly separate entrance area for the deers, basically just a way to showcase it differently, just to suggest you're entering a new place. Nothing particularly fancy. I think I need like a nice sign to build here, but just an entrance way, basically, for the deer. Anyways, Lida made these feeding items, which I've used in both inside the barn and inside the eventual area we're going to build in a minute. But he also made, I say he, I don't actually know, to be fair, but they also made a, I think it was for an African wild dog originally, but it's like a utility set. It's all like metal gates and lights and stuff like that. You know, like a, what is the word? You know, the back room where the staff operate, and like it's connected to the exhibit, and the staff go in there to get things for the exhibit and to look after the animals, blah, 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 blah. I'm going to build like a little room like that. I'm not really pointing much into it because you can't see it, but I use this set for that as well. Their set, I should say. Bloody Nora, I'm sorry. Either way, definitely check them out in the workshop. They do some beautiful, beautiful work. Really, really good stuff. I don't like using workshop items very often, but every now and again, I think I'm gonna dabble. The other thing I want to get is a boat. There's a ferry, which is humongous, and there's like the gondolas, which aren't appropriate, and there's the Indian fishing boat, I think it's called, which also isn't super appropriate. But I want like little boats along the canal, so I'm gonna see if anyone's built any good boats. Because I don't want to spend 3 hours making a boat. I wouldn't do a good job at the end of the day. Anyway, so this is the building I was on about. So that left room is where the staff are going to be. That's why it's all clad in metal. And, you know, the doors are a bit more utilitarian. And the left bit, well, the right bit now, is where the deer will sleep at night. I'm not putting too much into that because, again, you can't really see into it. But just enough that it looks okay and that it looks viable for the deer to have a nice larger area, nice and warm. I'm going to put some heaters in there and stuff like that. Just a nice area for the deers to chillax. But of course this building wouldn't disappear The idea is that the barn would maybe be torn down or shipped off somewhere else temporarily throughout the year, but the those are the feeders, by the way. Oh, maybe I didn't keep them in here. But the this building would be permanent. It would be used for other things throughout the year, so it still has to fit within the aesthetic of the city, essentially. Which is quite a nice getaway for me. Like, it's quite a nice cop-out, I suppose, in a way. Like, I know how to build these buildings. Like, I've gotten pretty good at it, I think. So the fact that I can build basically everything in this style makes my life a little bit easier. Obviously, I had to build the barn. And the reason the barn took so long is like, oh no, I have to do something else. I have to finally change my theming. It's deeply upsetting for me. But yeah, just doing a little detail work on the building. Just making it look pretty. Silence. That was really the moment it came together a little bit. It's just swapping the left building into limestone and keeping the right building as brick really helped separate them and just make it look a lot nicer. Big old door, which I should have kept that door. You're going to see me, I'm going to get rid of this door because the door on the inside couldn't be big enough to match it, basically. In reality, does that matter at all? No! But I did it anyway. So this is the backdrop. There's a proper word, I can't remember it. The set I was talking about, fantastically well made. I love the lights as well, these triple, quadruple spotlights, I should say. Beautiful stuff. And again, you're never actually going to see this, but I just want to give them a shout out because they do some brilliant work and it's worth checking them out on the Steam Workshop. So finally working on the actual habitat, which again is not going to be anything too... The habitat itself, where the you spend most of the time, is going to be pretty chilled, but you know, obviously we've built some buildings around the outside and that's where all the work is at the moment. Spent ages picking the right bloody colour, got there in the end. Just building a little chain link fence, again, sticking down a staff member to test it out. The idea is adults will be able to see over the fence, unless you're a short adult, and children will be able to see through the chain link, is the general idea. If you happen to fall outside of those, then you're screwed. Basically. This is what it is. Grow older. Or grow younger. Alright, those are your only two options. More trees. Just, again, I hate empty space. It really gets into my brain. Which is fairly self-deprecating when you think about it. But it really bothers me. It's my coffee shop. It is actually just a coffee shop. I did want to build a little marijuana sign. I'm not going to lie. But... unfortunately, these LED... Well, I wanted to build a smiley face first. I don't like the LEDs they've given us, unfortunately. The custom signs, the already made signs, are really good. They're so fantastic. But the sticks and the curves that we can actually build our own things with is very, very limited. Unfortunately, it's really hard to actually make anything with them, as far as I can see. Unless you made something fairly large. So I can't really do much with them, unfortunately. This is kind of what I was talking about earlier, so this is obviously the main bridge over... This is going to cross from the right-hand side, which, by the way, is going to be a red light district, is the current thinking for the salamander. I think red lights... Look, I think it'd be weird to do an Amsterdam spy build and not do the red light district. Obviously, there's no women in the windows, or men in the windows, as there is in reality. There will be fire salamanders. I think that's actually quite cool. Like, just imagine walking down and you've got all these like red light glass doors on the side and it's just a fire salamander in there and it's all doused in red neon. I think it's gonna look really cool actually. I'm quite excited about it. Yeah. So working on the actual habitat. I only did this today. Did everything else first before the actual bloody deer habitat. And yeah, just ends up being fairly... I put a lot more work into it than I did the badger one, let's put it that way. There's a lot of rock work, a lot of foliage work. It ends up feeling pretty packed with stuff, considering it's quite a small space. Messing around with the textures there. But I want to talk about this a little bit more, because I think some people out there may take slight issue with me doing something based on a red light district, which is, I guess, understandable. Like, everyone's got their own perspectives on that kind of thing. Especially younger viewers, or people... older viewers who have kids watching this, or maybe just older viewers, it doesn't suit your sensibilities, that's fine. Regardless of your perspective on the red light district. I mean, my perspective is that it's not something I would ever partake in myself. I have been when I went to Amsterdam like 6-7 years ago, whatever it was. We did, you know, tour through and have a look, because, you know, you just do, don't you? It's not something I would partake in, but as far as I'm concerned, what people do... I don't really want to get into a whole thing about this, but what people do with their bodies... as far as I'm concerned, it's completely their own prerogative. You should be able to do whatever you want. It's your body. You know, I don't like the idea of policing that in any way whatsoever. And considering it is such... Even though they are trying to shut it down a little bit, or at least there's talk about, you know, culling it to some extent, it's such an integral part of what people think, tourist-wise anyway, when people think of Amsterdam. And I accept that it is very much a tourist thing, that I think it would be silly to not touch on it, basically. So, yeah. Anyways, I really don't want to get into a big discussion about that. That's just my stance on it. If people have a different one, that's fine. I'm just trying to explain myself. Still not sure whether I'm going to put lights in the trees. I kind of want to, but I'm not sure. Just trying to make things a little bit more interesting. Just again, filling areas with benches and planters, trees, lights. There's anything to... I love that. Decided I need to bring that over to the other side. You know, you can put a cam in things, and then you can make the TV show it, so you can actually have the cam constantly showing, like, into the beaver, into the badger burrow, which is pretty awesome. Right, anyways, so we shall... I know that was very hard to keep track of, because it was very, very quick, which is kind of why you do shorter builds, I suppose, and then time-lapse them, because that was 1500 speed, as I say. It's super speedy. But we'll hop in-game, I'll give you a proper tour of everything, and we'll chuck in some deer, and yeah, I'll see you in a sec. Okay, so this actually started happening towards the end of my video. Yeah, whatever. I have no idea why. Has it stopped now? Oh, it's only when I hit... Go away! It's only here when I hit play. So I don't know what that's all about, that kind of vibrating. But it's something that needs sorting, really. Okay, so, oh, first things first, I got a little image. These were actually inspired by Lyder as well, so shout out to them. Dale Deer, there you go, there's our fallow deer sign. I'm going to put, I think the idea is to have another one separate in there and have the information, maybe like a smaller one there with the information on it, something like that, but that's the basics of what I'm doing. Is that not a lit one, though? No, it's not. I need a lit one. I'm going to get lit, fam. Screen panel. One by one, lit. There we go, we got lit. Oh, so cool. Lovely. So that's much better. Look at that, beautiful. Shuffle that a little to the side. A little bit up. There we go. And we've got one for the badger as well. So this is my fallow deer habitat. I know you, again, couldn't really see it, although I was distracted when talking about sex workers. so this is the fallow deer habitat. I'd say I went a little harder on the foliage. I found this new bush that I haven't used much. What's it called? The kind of clear, but dog rose. Dog rose is pretty awesome. Decided to use the olive trees because they're new for the pack as well. And I hadn't really used them before, and just this central tree I think is really, really cool looking. All twisty and turny. Wherever it suits the habitat is a whole other kettle of fish, but I think it's a perfectly nice little habitat, really. You know, just nice. Just nice. There's the main building, the living area for them. Got some hay bales. I can actually find out. This was another blueprint. I completely forgot about it. That I downloaded ages ago for the other De Oratio that I downloaded for the Halloween zoo. So I've got those in there. This is, again, you're not really meant to spend any time in here, so whatever. Same in here. This is here, but it's a bit empty and dead. I just wanted to mess around with it and also have my badger burrow cam. every time I see that ferry, it's like a UFO arriving. So yeah, there's that. There's our little viewing area for it. This is a little staff area, obviously. Off the side, no entrance. So the actual entrance to the back door area, the staging area, and to the gate inwards, all blocked off. I think I'll just end up sticking... Oh, I did. There's a building there. Might put a couple of windows in there, but nice and blocked off. Although, I really do want this to wrap around somehow. I don't really see how that would work. Anyways, let's head forward. Obviously, I'll show you this at nighttime as well. There's the entranceway. This looks... I did this off video. This is the large antlers and the little antler lights connected together. It looks really cool, actually, at nighttime. Security cam. Seating area, viewing area for inside the barn, which as you can see, like I mentioned before, it's got quite a lot of... woodwork in the middle just to kind of sustain it. Whether this makes any sense, by the way, it's neither here nor there. I honestly couldn't tell you. I've filled the feeders a little bit, but I've clearly done a fairly terrible job of doing so, considering they are. So there's our Christmas tree with all the ribbons around the side and the fencing, big old tree. I put some stockings in the tree as well and some presents down the side. And there's the tower. I said, I'm pretty proud of the tower, not gonna lie. Like I said, you can see the stars there and the little star there and the star on top, but I think you still get a feeling for the original design that I did. Which, yeah, I was pretty proud of it. Yeah! little Christmas market walks. There's all our stands. These are all connected to paths. These all work. It was genuinely quite hard work to make that happen. But there you go. I think it feels quite Christmassy. I'd like even more of these stalls in here, really, but it is very difficult without like making it massive, you know. A little bit of Bernie's Bakes. I'd like something here. I'm probably going to stick a bench here and maybe something cupcakes there for Bernie's Bakes. Added a tree. I need to do some stuff on this side as well. Oh, there's more to do than I thought there was, but it's fine. It's just little details. There's the other main walkway again. All these, the vendors, six different vendors all in this area. And of course, this whole area here is kind of new as well. Like, I did basically all of this since the last video. Head down there. Right, let's check it out at nighttime. Again, can't hit play. Maybe I'll hit play. It's all vibrating. I do need to update my game. I'm still on the review copy. Okay, so there's the bridge all lit up just like the one over there. And let's check it out. There's our little coffee shop all lit up. Just had the van's not really... I'm just assuming it's for the coffee shop owner, basically, and then they're going to drive through the city. I just wanted something sitting there to fill this space, if I'm totally honest. But yeah, Street Fox Coffee. Hey. Head up the bit. Obviously, this area will be developed later on. But yeah, there we go. Christmas... Isn't that pretty? Christmas market. So I've connected the... what are these called again? Antlers across the lampposts. It's kind of like a thing that you head to. It kind of inspired a little bit by the Blackpool lights, which were a big part of my childhood. All the these things are all lit up at night as well. They've all got fairy lights over the top and then lots of lit up display things there. All these little beer things as well. There's the entrance. But isn't that nice? You know, the fact that you can connect them together like that, it looks really natural. Well, not natural, you know what I mean, but very dramatic. Head down here. So you'd look into there. That's all nicely warmed up. There's the feeders and you would obviously see the deer. This is one reason I've started to struggle, and I had lights on this side of the bridge and I got rid of them because there's so many lights that it's causing weird shadow issues more and more. But a big shout out to Lida for those. Moving forward. A little seating area here. This area is not 100% done. I need a light. I might just tell you what. Tell you blim blamming what we're going to do. We're going to do it right now. Candles have become a bit of a thing, but I'm going to put these on. There you go, that actually makes a big difference. Nice little romantic seating area. You can sit in here, look into the exhibit, and view your animals. And that is about it, I suppose. Obviously, I developed this area a little bit more as well. And this is the other main area where you'd walk down and see all the things at nighttime. There it is. So that is the city. So I can't believe that's two episodes worth of work. It feels like 10. But yeah, that's the city so far. Yeah, let's get some deer in. Okay, this is really annoying me. I'm sorry about this. I will get this fixed for the next video. I'll try to get this fixed for the next video. I mean, at the end of the day, most of what you see me do is building things. I get that. But what we can do is we can take nice screenshots. If nothing else, we can take nice screenshots. The fallow deer is probably my favourite animal in the pack. I just think the design is remarkable. It's so good. There's something about the skull shape that I really, really like. I don't know if that's weird, but the skull shape is always what sticks out to me with these guys. There's the other one. Is she on the way? I'm sure she's on the way. They met under the olive tree. Only other thing I'm considering is lighting this area. Oh, she's going inside. Come on. First time into the barn. You can do it. What's your name again? Eleanor. Come on, Eleanor. No. Ah, barn too scary. They can get in. I did put Kyron in at some point just to, again, test the height against the feeder and against the wall. I've got to say, I'm really proud of this. I think, like, just looking at it like that, I think this is one of the best things I've ever built. Like, I'm really happy with how it turned out, especially considering, I know I say this a lot, but I don't consider myself good at building buildings, you know? I don't really count that as part of my skill set, so. Hey, she's finally here. Rosemary's here. Hello, Rosemary. You really know Rosemary. Rosemary's here. But, yeah, I guess that's about it, folks. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. I promise we'll spend more time with the animals next video. I'll just sort out the flickering, really. And let me know what you think of the park build so far. Thank you so much for joining me. Please do throw me a like down below if you enjoyed the video. Give it a share, all that kind of stuff. Planet Zoo takes a lot of work. And doesn't always necessarily do that well, which is kind of why I haven't been covering it as much as I think people would like in the past. I'm trying to get past that completely for this series because I'm really enjoying it and I want to do this. And I'm very excited about seeing this as a finished build. So hopefully don't fret too much about that. But, you know, every like, every comment, every share, all that stuff really does help me psychologically more than anything else. So I'd really appreciate that. And you'd be such a lovely person. Thank you for joining me. Cheers much as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.